Financial economics is a deep subject, my boy. It takes years of study. Let me worry about these matters, and you look after yours. You must become more efficient, increase your production, cut down on your expenses, and become a better businessman. I'm always willing to help in these matters.
To cover the interest on the money they had borrowed, merchants were forced to raise their prices. Wage earners complained that their wages were too low. Employers refused to pay higher wages, claiming that they would be ruined. Farmers could not get a fair price for their produce. Housewives complained that food was getting too dear. And finally, some people went on strike, a thing previously unheard of. Others had become poverty-stricken, and their friends and relatives could not afford to help them. Most had forgotten the real wealth all around, the fertile soils, the great forests, the minerals, and cattle. They could only think of the money, which always seemed so scarce. But they never questioned the system. They believed the government was running it. The economic situation got worse. The wage earners were convinced that the bosses were making too much profit. The bosses said that their workers were too lazy and weren't doing an honest day's work. And everyone was blaming everyone else. The governors could not come up with an answer, and besides, the immediate problem seemed to be to help the poverty-stricken. They started up welfare schemes and made laws forcing people to contribute to them. These welfare schemes gave some relief, but before long, the problem was back, and more money was needed to cope. The cost of these schemes rose higher and higher, and the size of government grew. Most of the governors were sincere men, trying to do their best. They didn't like asking for more money from their people, and finally, they had no choice but to borrow money from Fabian and his friends. They had no idea how they were going to repay. In desperation, the governors decided to seek Fabian's advice. They considered him very wise, and he seemed to know how to solve money matters. He listened to them explain all their problems, and finally, he answered.
Many people cannot solve their own problems. They need someone to do it for them. Surely you agree that most people have the right to be happy and to be provided with the essentials of life. One of our great sayings is, all men are equal, is it not? Well, the only way to balance things up is to take the excess wealth from the rich and give it to the poor. Introduce a system of taxation. The more a man has, the more he must pay.
As things got worse, they tried wage control, price control, and all sorts of controls. The government tried to get more money through sales tax, payroll tax, and all sorts of taxes. Someone noted that from the wheat farmer right through to the housewife, there were over 50 taxes on a loaf of bread. Experts arose and some were elected to government. But after each yearly meeting, they came back with almost nothing achieved, except for the news that taxes were to be restructured. But overall, the total tax always increased. Fabian began to demand his interest payments, and larger portion of the tax money was needed to pay him. Then came party politics. The people started arguing about which group of governors could best solve the problems. They argued about personalities, idealism, party labels, everything except the real problem. The councils were getting into trouble. In one town, the interest on the debt exceeded the amount of rates which were collected in a year. Throughout the land, the unpaid interest kept increasing. Interest was charged on unpaid interest. Gradually, much of the real wealth of the country came to be owned or controlled by Fabian and his friends, and with it came greater control over people. However, the control was not yet complete. They knew that the situation would not be secure until every person was controlled. Most people opposing the systems could be silenced by financial pressure or suffer public ridicule. To do this, Fabian and his friends purchased most of the newspapers, TV and radio stations, and he carefully selected people to operate them. Many of these people had a sincere desire to improve the world, but they never realized how they were being used. Their solutions always dealt with the effects of the problem, never the cause. There were several different newspapers, one for the right wing, one for the left wing, one for the workers, one for the bosses, and so on. It didn't matter much which one you believed in, so long as you didn't think about the real problem. Fabian's plan was almost at its completion. The whole country was in debt to him. Through education and the media, he had control of people's minds. They were able to think and believe only what he wanted them to. After a man has far more money than he can possibly spend for pleasure, what is left to excite him? For those with a ruling class mentality, the answer is power, raw power over other human beings. The idealists were used in the media and in government, but the real controllers that Fabian sought were those of the ruling class mentality. Most of the goldsmiths had become this way. They knew the feeling of great wealth, but it no longer satisfied them. They needed challenge and excitement, and power over the masses was the ultimate game. They believed they were superior to all others. It's our right and our duty to rule. The masses don't know what is good for them. They need to be rallied and organized. To rule is our birthright.
Republika Hrvatska se našla u jednom vrtlogu gospodarske i financijske krize u kojoj se našao i svijet. Sve međunarodne financijske institucije kažu da je Hrvatska za razliku od mnogih dobro se snašla i dobro se borila sa tom krizom.
Zadužiti za još 500 milijuna eura, najavio je na današnjoj sjednici vlade ministar financija. Taj je sindicirani kredit namijenjen za vraćanje kredita podignutih prethodnih godina.
Ovo nije povećanje duga Republike Hrvatske, ovo je zaduživanje da bi se moglo vratiti dug koji je podignut prethodnih godina.